no more iconic hiking Appalachian Trail. Most of us take it for granted as if it's always been there.
In fact, the trail was in large part the creation of two men, one of whom grew up in Washington County. Jeffrey Ryan, a writer from Maine, tells their story in his book, Blazing Ahead, Benton McKay, Myron Avery, and the rivalry that built the Appalachian Trail.
McKay had the vision for the trail. Avery made it happen. What they created runs about 2,200 miles from Springer Mountain, Georgia, to the summit of Mount Katahdin.
Writing about the trail was a labor of love for Jeff Ryan, who has walked every mile of it.
Well, I hiked it over 28 years with the same friend, and I wrote a book about that. So we did it from 1985 to 2013. And while we were out on the trail, I kept thinking someone was responsible for all of this coming into our focus.
Two guys in particular were responsible, Benton McKay and Myron Avery. Why did you want to write a book about those two, the focus on those two, and not an overall history of the trail?
Well, those two are really the doer and the dreamer, and it all started with McKay growing up in Massachusetts and coming up with the idea of the trail being a place to go recreate and restore ourselves. And he really needed to have a doer like Myron Avery from Lubeck, Maine, to push it through.
You mentioned Myron from Lubeck. Also an interesting story about going to Bowdoin.
Yes, he was accepted at Bowdoin, and his family did not have the means to send him there. So the rumor is that the town raised the money and sent him there, and I think it really affected him for life. He felt like he needed to prove that they made the right decision.
How did he eventually prove himself helping out on this trail? It sounds like he had a wheel that he used.
Yes, he measured the whole thing with a bike wheel, and he had it down to the tenth of a mile. In fact, there's a running gag that in the archives there is not a picture of Myron Avery. There are very few without the bike wheel in it. So he was constantly taking notes, and he was obsessed with marking the trail and describing the trail.
One of the things that's interesting, that I always find interesting in reading a book like this, is not only what did happen, but what didn't happen. So let's talk about some of the proposals that were out there that thankfully, I think we can say, never came to fruition. One of them was building an automobile road, a skyline drive, as it were, over the summits of the Green Mountains in Vermont and the Presidential Range in New Hampshire. How close did that come to happening?
Well, I think it actually was gaining momentum for quite a while. The impetus behind it was the growth of the automobile and the idea that people needed places to go and see. So when Skyline Drive got built and was received Wow. with great fanfare
Skyline Drive
in Virginia, in the Shenandoahs, they immediately attached on the Blue Ridge Parkway, and that whole movement was gaining speed because of the rural areas getting more money, the transportation people, the auto clubs, the lodging group, that whole thing. And so it really was gaining currency, and actually the Green Mountain version came fairly close to becoming a real thing.
And this was back in the 1930s. It was during the Depression, so it would have been a public works project. So there was a real momentum. And the cars, of course, the car business was exploding. There was a real momentum. Another idea that did not happen was to have the trail end at its northern point, not on the summit of Mount Katahdin in Maine, but on the summit of Mount Washington in New Hampshire.
Correct.
How close did that come to happening?
Well, that actually was the going proposition until Avery got involved. And being from Maine, he really wanted to push the trail up into Maine. So once he got involved, that became more and more of a reality. But what was interesting about that was there was a move, an idea basically at the time that you had to have trail clubs build the trail. And there were no clubs in Maine. And Avery pushed back saying there are not enough people in Maine to make the clubs first. We need to make the trail first and have the clubs come later. So he and another guy named Walter Green, who was a Broadway actor that spent half his time in Maine, were the ones who really pushed the trail concept in Maine and built it and marked it and got it going.
You write about how McKay and Avery did not get along. How close was it to this trail not happening?
Well, I don't think it was as much not happening, but they had a difference of opinion that really came to a head when Skyline Drive came into being. Skyline Drive started taking shape and was actually laid down right over the top of the Appalachian Trail as it existed. And they were shocked. No one had been in the loop with this happening. So when it did happen, it precipitated an argument between Avery and Mackay. Mackay felt that the trail and wilderness were linked from the very beginning. It was his whole idea. And Avery was really obsessed with building a trail from end to end.
Obviously, this was not an easy venture. It took enormous work to get it done. But what you meant or make note of in the book is that it's likely that this is going to be around forever. This is an achievement that will likely never go away.
That's correct, and it's an amazing accomplishment and it shows that the dreamer and the doer don't always have to be exactly on the same page, but if they can get together, they can accomplish amazing things.
Now, for much of this year, Jeffrey Ryan has actually been promoting his book by traveling around the U.S. in a 1985 Volkswagen Vanagon. He's put tens of thousands of miles on that rig, camping much of the time, and absolutely loves it.
If you would like to meet Jeff Ryan and hear more about his book and maybe hear some stories about the VW Vanagon, he has events coming up in Maine next month, three of them. You can find those on our website.
All right, we already read that part. He'll be at the Bangor Public Library on December 7th. Did we mention that?
We did not. South Point Public Library on the 9th, Thomas Memorial Library in Cape Elizabeth on the 14th.
Okay, coming up, Peggy Kaiser in the 207 kitchen. She's got a trick up her sleeve on what to do with all that turkey.